Hi everyone. First of all, I would like to thank you very much for taking the time to come over here. I'm Sebi Mers. I work as market development specialist at Kordsa. I'm going to take you through how we got into this industry, what are the available products, and what are the products to be launched in the future. So, first of all, I would like to talk about the strategy house in three business fields. We rely on our strategy house. The first part is simply constituted by the values. We have customer focus, continuous improvement, the employee engagement, so on and so forth. In addition to all those, in all of the business lines, we have three pillars. And I'm sure you have heard of the Red Ocean coding system. And in that red part, we have a competitive, actually high level of competition, where we have the cost as the competitive aspect. Whereas in blue, we have more added value. So this is what we try to do, shift from the red ocean to the blue ocean. So this is actually the growth in adjacent is what we call the blue ocean. So for the strategic growth, this is what we care about. Let me take you through the history of Kordsa very briefly. Tire reinforcement technologies is our main field, and we are the market leader in that respect. So out of every three aircraft tires, two of them are reinforced by Kordsa, and for the car tires, out of every three, one is reinforced by Kordsa. Composite technologies and construction reinforcement technologies, I'm going to focus on the composite technologies today. Let me take you through the financials. So we have the regional and we have the breakage by business line. Between year-on-year comparison, between 2018 and 19, there is an increase from 377 to 461, 12% of which is comprised by composite business line. So when you look at Kordsa, it's very much embedded in R&D. For every product it produces, it is trying to create value. The first R&D center was established in 2008. The second one was established in 2016. 786 total applications for patent, and the granted number is 185. R&D is one of the very strategical and critical points for us in this respect. So I'm going to take you through our composite business line, but I also would like to focus on the different details of the other business lines, because what we earn as a competence here is actually very much simply paving the way for the composite business line. So as Yan, we are producing our own raw material, starting from the polymerization. We are producing the yarn through spinning. We do twisting, weaving, going through the chemical phases. We do the dipping and the other parts. As you could see, nylon 66 and polyester PET yarn, we are the market leader in these two fields. And for 45 years, Kordsa has been actively operating in yarn and weaving. It has a very high level of know-how and experience. And how do we do that? As an intermediate product production, we are involved in weaving and prepreg production. And this is very much the essential strategy of ours in this respect. So You see all of the locations through the globe. We have 12 facilities in 5 countries. We have more than 4,500 employees. Places marked in black belong to the Composites Corporation and business lines. In Istanbul, we have a composite center of excellence in Kurtköy, and in Europe and Middle East, we are serving these two regions from Kurtköy. We have created another chain of value in the United States. We have one prepreg production center and one reinforcement center. This is very much actually constituting one leg of that strategy which I have shared with you at the very beginning. The composite business line has organic and inorganic growth. Let me take you through that as well. For the first time ever in 2016, with 30 million investment in Kurtköy, we opened a composite technology center of excellence, and this is certified with AS9100. And in United States, as I told you before, in terms of weaving and prepreg, there are different investments. So in aviation and aerospace, we have become a competitive supplier in this respect. And we have so many different products which are produced at different locations. Let me talk about the sites, what we are doing in such sites and what are the competencies we have. CTCE, which is located in Kurtköy, as I indicated before, you have probably heard of this, in joint collaboration with Sabancı University, in order to improve the academic and private sector industry relationship, we have started this initiative. It's a full-story building. First, we have the prepreg production, and then we have the advanced composite materials testing lab. The third and fourth floors are managed by Sabancı University, and in the last floor, we have the R&D team. So this is what we do. From the scratch until the final production of the product, we can do end-to-end production. So in line with the specifications of the part, we produce the raw materials. But all throughout that cycle, from the chemicals to the machinery performance, everything, every detail could be worked on. There is custom-made production, so to say. I'm going to take you through details in every phase. And in addition to this, as Kortsa, from yarn to weaving, from weaving to prepreg, we are doing the production. We buy so many different materials in the form of carbon, aramide, glass fiber, in the form of yarn, and then we weave them. And we provide this to our stakeholders, and hence the production of the composite materials. Let me take you through the labs. First of all, we have the additive manufacturing lab. So here, from metal, from powder metal, or out of high-performance plastics, composites, we could produce complex parts using those materials. The production methods are improved over here. So different materials are combined with one another, hence the formation of different structures. At the same time, we have a lab on advanced composite production manufacturing tags. So, you know, infusion, RTM, the simplest method until the fiber rollout procedure. So anything and everything which could be needed for the composite production, we have the machinery and equipment. As Kortsa and University, we are working on those production techniques, and we try to improve them every time. As well as that, additive
satılmalı
have the computational mechanics lab, where we do the part simulation from the parts. For example, we can work with the simulation of a crash using a commercial software in line with the needs. We have polymer process lab, thermoplastics resin systems are studied here, for example. In the kitchens, you know, from the containers to the high engineering parts which are used in the aircrafts are done here. We do the additive materials, we combine them at different formulas, and we try to produce high reinforced, high resistance materials. We have the chemistry lab, and this is actually sort of a very regular, ordinary chemistry lab. And this is where our colleagues work on the reduction of hundreds of ideas to tens of ideas, which are feasible, which are doable. So they are actually sort of, they do the material characterization, they do the analysis, and they are simply filtering them out, whether they are going to be feasible, viable, they are aligned with the objectives, so on and so forth. For example, curing temperatures, they could check those over here. Or is there sufficient level of energy which is used to power the material? So that's what they work on. And they create small samples, and they make sure that they have the right outputs and outcomes, and they check whether those have the right mechanical properties or not. And as I told you before, these are under the control of Sabancı University. We work on some joint projects with a different number of universities. Sabancı University, just like they work with us, also work with different companies. It's an open innovation center, so it's a test area, and you just need to simply contact Sabancı University. We have prepreg production line over here. Okay, what do we do as Corsa? Let me focus on that part. So first of all, weaving, prepreg and sandwich panel production. From 1K to 50K, all of the fabrics could be used to produce these. And up to 160 centimeters, there's this production in the fabric width, and we could do different types of weaving. And in the prepreg line, mainly we work with thermoset prepregs and thermoplastic prepregs. The thermoplastic prepregs are also available. Autoclave, press and oven. We have different types of production fields. Let me talk about the prepreg machinery. It's hot mass. So what is that? We produce the resin film, and then in a different machine, we do the impregnation to the fabric, thus the preparation of the prepregs, and that gives us the capability to work at very sensitive resin rates, which means that this could be done very sensitively. We also work on UD prepregs, which starts from fiber. They are non-crimp, there is no stitch, so they are unilateral prepregs. And in the same building, we have the sandwich panels, which are prepared from honeycombs, which are mainly used for the interior parts of the aerospace and aircrafts for the aerospace industry, like the galley, kitchen, oven, because these products are much more lightweight and they are more durable.
Sizin geliştirdiğiniz ürünlerden bahsetmek istedim.
Let me talk about the products which we prepared, Prescure preparings. They are, if there's going to be a production in higher numbers, mainly Prescure is opted for in six or seven minutes. We prepare the product. There's something very important here. They're mainly custom made, so they are quality A, and structurally speaking, we could also designate some products. There seems to be a confusion over here. So a visual material could be also structural. So both visual and structural materials could be also produced. That's what I would have to clarify. As I told you before, every 6 or 7 minutes we have developed the resin systems. And we very much simply depend on the needs of the customers over here. Autoclave cure preprex, it's actually, it has to do with the temperature, the pressure, and vacuum. So you might simply fill the gaps. You are able to fill the gaps in the pass. Many structural parts are produced using this production technique. And depending on different features, depending on different curing temperatures, we have developed our own products, and they are now launched to the market and they are used. We have more traditional methods, of oven curing is one of those. Mainly they are preferred in marine industry, lower temperatures and higher curing periods are necessary. So this is what we have developed for this industry. Defense industry and some phenolic based preprex were also developed by us, so that helmets, in the helmet production or in the body armor production, such products are used and they are available in the market. And until now I have talked about thermostat and epoxy base, but there is also thermoplastic range preprex, and mainly and we are talking about products which could be reused. So that's what we are working on right at the moment. Polypropylene and polyamide 6.6. We have two different types of thermoplastic resins, and they could be produced at different levels of resin. Up to 4 times we have done the implementation. In case there's a different need, we will do this prototyping and we will launch it to market, mainly in automotive and in sports and recreational equipment. We see such materials and we continue to develop such products. Well, everything I have told you has been developed in a very short period, as 3 years. In addition to this, we have developed so many different processes and products, and it's not possible for me to cover all those. But we first have to understand the need of the client, and based on that we are producing our own material. That's actually what we are trying to do. That's why we have a number of products in the pipeline. Autoclave surface film and press surface film, very soon they will be available in the market. Adhesive film for metal-metal or metal composite adhesion, that's a required product, and that has been developed. Very soon that will be released to the market. As well as that, we have out-of autoclave translucent preprek. It's a translucent resin system, and it's going to be oven cure, and very soon it is going to be available. It's in the pipeline. And let's talk about the American market, which has been developed inorganically, what we're doing over there. So first of all, fabric development and textile products. We have purchased, acquired two different companies. So for 50 and 60 years, they have been doing weaving, ceramic, carbon fibers using so many different types of yarns with a product number more than 2,000. That was a rather critical market for us because by acquisition, even though indirectly, we have become the supplier under the program of 787, and mainly they are used in aircraft engines and in different parts of the aircrafts. As I've told you before, this is rather critical for us because they were certified, already certified and endorsed in the aviation industry. So, as well as aviation industry, they are offering products to so many different industries, Mars expedition programs, the space suit fabrics, all the trainers by Nike, they are using those products. And actually, there are so many different well-known companies which we can't simply name over here. Advanced Honeycomb Technologies, this is the honeycomb producer, and still, again, it is certified in aviation, phenolic-based, Nomex and craft oil is used to produce honeycomb, and unlike the other companies, this is standing out. Mainly they are solvent-based, the phenolic-based resins. However, here they are doing it water-based. So they have a very special feature. We have the recent edition of Axiom Materials, which was acquired 2 months ago, which is very recent. And they have oxytoxic matrix composites. Where are they used? Particularly in the aircraft engines, so at a temperature of around high 100 centigrade degrees, they could still resist such high temperatures. And at the moment, by so many OEM, it is in the position of a single supplier. High temperature prepregs are also available, and mainly they want to have flame retardant materials, and we also have the structural prepregs and adhesive films. Well, of course, now that we are talking about aviation and aerospace, the reason is that because their quality requirements are very high. But in addition to those, we are offering products to so many different industries and companies, from marine to the sports and recreational equipment, to the mask producers, to the sneaker producers. When you look at the doors of the cockpit, the galleys, the ovens, they are among the products which we offer. And in short period of time, as a matter of fact, we were able to achieve this. The objective is to create the second Corsa out of the composite business line. This is work in progress. And in United States, we have completed that product structure. And now we have Europe in the pipeline. And we would like to thank you so much for being there and being here to simply hear this presentation. If you have any questions, now...
Farklı üniversitelerle işbirliği...
When you said that you have cooperation with so many different universities, could you explain that?
Örneğin, bir OEM'le...
For example, with an OEM, when you talk to an OEM, in line with the part which is going to be produced, there could be some design or engineering specifications. We go and talk to the different university teams. Well, we have, of course, non-disclosure agreements from the very beginning, which are signed by both parties. So, because that's the case, we start the process by including them from the very beginning. Sabancı University is not informed about such processes because, indeed, we are two separate structures in the same building. And likewise, maybe they get to work with our competitors, and we don't know that. This is why we have established that place, actually. Every safety precaution has been taken to ensure that. Well, as I told you before, we have joint projects, but we are isolated.